Oisin in the land of Tírnanog. One day in Ireland, long, long ago, the warriors of the Fianna were hunting deer along the shores of Loch Lean in County Kerry. Suddenly, into their view came the most beautiful woman they had ever seen. She was riding on a magnificent white horse, and she wore a beautiful, bright blue dress. Her long golden hair was like silk and hung down to her waist. Finn, the leader of the Fianna, spoke to her. "What is your name? And tell us, what land have you come from?" She said, "I am Niamh of the Golden Hair, and my father is the king of Tírnanog." All the warriors were silenced by her great beauty and by the lovely sound of her voice. "I have heard of a warrior called Oisin," she said, "and of his great courage and the beautiful poetry he writes. I have come here to find him and take him back to the land of Tírnanog." Now Oisin was the son of Finn, the Fianna leader, and he was a great warrior and poet. Oisin then spoke, "Tell me, what sort of land is this Tírnanog?" "Tírnanog is the land of youth," Niamh replied. "It is a very happy place where there is no sorrow and no pain. Any wish you make there comes true, and no one ever grows old. If you come with me, you will see it all for yourself." Oisin got on the white horse behind Niamh and said farewell to his father and friends. He promised he'd return soon, and they galloped away and out of sight. The warriors of the Fianna were sad to see their hero Oisin go, but Finn reminded them of his promise to return, and they felt a little bit happier then. When Niamh and Oisin reached the land of Tírnanog, they were made welcome by the king and the queen, and a great feast was held in their honour. It was indeed a wonderful land, just as Niamh had said. During the day, Oisin hunted for deer, and in the evening he feasted and told stories about his father, Finn, and the Fianna back in Ireland. Niamh and Oisin had never felt happier. They were madly in love, and before too long, they were married. Oisin was very happy with his new life, and the time passed quickly. Eventually, he began to think about returning to Ireland to visit his family and friends. Niamh didn't want him to go, but at last she said, "Take my white horse and it will carry you safely to Ireland. But whatever happens, do not get off the white horse and do not let your feet touch the soil of Ireland. If you do, you will never see Tírnanog nor me again." Niamh did not tell Oisin that although he thought he'd only been away for a few years, he'd really been in Tírnanog for 300 years. When Oisin arrived back in Ireland, everything there seemed so strange to him. There was no trace of his father and the Fianna, and all the people he met looked small and weak to him. One day, as he rode through the beautiful Glen na Small, he saw some men trying to move a large rock. Oisin was a kind man and said to the men, I will help you. When the men turned around, they were terrified to see the giant Oisin on a white horse. Oisin stooped from his saddle and lifted the heavy rock with one hand and set it where the men wanted it put. But as he lifted the heavy rock, the strap on his saddle broke, and Oisin fell to the ground. Right there and then, the white horse disappeared, and the men saw before them an old, old man with long white hair and a long beard. "Where is my father and the warriors of the Fianna?" Finn asked. When he heard that they had been dead for many, many years, he was heartbroken. He told the people many tales of his deeds with the Fianna and of all their adventures together in the times past. He then told them of his magical time in Tir na n'Og and of his beautiful wife, whom he would never see again. Oisin died soon after, but the wonderful legend of Oisin in the land of Tir na n'Og lives on to this day.